Hello friends, in this video I am going to discuss one numerical which is related to analysis of acceleration of slider crank mechanism. So let's start the numerical which is related to analysis of acceleration of slider crank mechanism. And the numerical is, in a slider crank mechanism, crank rotates clockwise at constant speed 400 rpm. The crank is 200 mm and connecting rod is 800 mm long. Determine the linear velocity and acceleration at midpoint of the connecting rod. Angular velocity and angular acceleration of the connecting rod at crank angle of 45 degree from inner dead center position. So here this is our numerical. So in this numerical we have a slider crank mechanism. So this is our slider crank mechanism, and here we have four links. BO, this is representing crank. AB, it is representing connecting rod. This A is representing the slider, and other is the fixed link. So about this fixed link, the slider is sliding, and here we are considering point O, which is also on the fixed link. So this crank is rotating with respect to this point O. So here we have this slider crank mechanism, and in this slider crank mechanism the crank is rotating at constant speed 400 rpm. So speed of this particular crank in terms of rpm is given, it is 400 rpm. And the dimension of crank, BO is represented as the crank and AB is represented as the connecting rod. So the dimension of crank is given, BO is 200 mm and connecting rod AB is 800 mm long. Now we have to determine the linear velocity as well as the linear acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod. So we will mark some point. Let us mark a point D in between of the connecting rod. Let us consider D is the midpoint of this connecting rod. So here we have to define the linear velocity as well as the linear acceleration at this point D, which is at the midpoint. So at the midpoint of the connecting rod, we have to define the velocity and acceleration, as well as we also have to determine the angular velocity and angular acceleration of the connecting rod at an crank angle. Here at a crank angle 45 degree from IDC position. So here if this crank is completing one revolution in terms of circle, so this particular point is called IDC or inner dead center, and this particular point is called outer dead center. So from inner dead center, this crank is making angle theta, that is 45 degree. So for this particular condition, when crank is rotating with angular velocity omega, we have to determine the angular velocity of the connecting rod as well as the angular acceleration of the connecting rod at this particular angle 45 degree from IDC position. So let's start the solution. So first of all, I'll write down all the given values. So we have these given values. Length of the crank is given 200 mm. So it will be in meter, 0.2 meter. Length of the connecting rod, it is 800 mm. So it will be in meter, 0.8 meter. And the speed of the crank, it is given in terms of RPM. So it will be 400 RPM. And the value of theta is also given. So theta is 45 degree. So this is made by the crank from the inner dead center. So these given values we have. Now first calculation we will do on the basis of this speed of the crank BO. So NBO we have 400 rpm. So on that basis we can define the angular velocity of crank omega. Here it is given, this crank is rotating in clockwise direction with angular velocity omega. So this omega or omega BO for the crank we can define. So this is the formula, 2 pi NBO by 60. So N value we have 400 rpm. So omega BO will be 2 pi into 400 by 60. So it will be 41.8 radian per second. Now this is the value of angular velocity of crank BO. Now we have the angular velocity. So we can define the linear velocity of the crank or linear velocity of point B with respect to point O. And linear velocity we can define perpendicular to BO. So this VB we can define on the basis of this omega BO, and this will be the direction of this VB we can consider perpendicular to this BO. And here we have only one component, that is the VB, and here we can define, if we want to define the acceleration for this particular condition, so we can only define the radial acceleration component. Here we will not define the tangential acceleration because this crank is rotating with constant angle of velocity. So this particular VB we can define on the basis of omega. So first I will define all the velocities. So omega r is generally used as a formula to define the linear velocity. So VBO or VB, that is equals to omega BO into OB. So if we put all these values, omega value and OB value, so we will have this VBO, it is 8.37 meter per second. So here we have one known magnitude of velocity of point B with respect to point O. Now on the basis of this velocity magnitude as well as the direction, we can find out the velocity of other component like velocity of point A with respect to point B and velocity of slider. So let's find out all other velocities, and for that we will draw a velocity diagram. So this velocity diagram we will draw with suitable scale, and here we have the magnitude of VBO. So this magnitude we will use to draw velocity diagram. So we will draw the velocity diagram on the basis of velocity of point B with respect to point O, point A with respect to point B, and the velocity of slider. So as we know here, this point A or this slider A is sliding with respect to this fixed link, and the direction of velocity we will consider when this crank is rotating in clockwise direction. So this point B will move in this direction. So this AB will also move in the same direction with some angular velocity, and this slider will go in this particular direction toward right. So the slider is moving in this direction, so VA we will consider in this particular direction only. So here this VA we have to define, as well as the velocity of point A with respect to point B we also have to define on the basis of this magnitude. So let's draw the velocity diagram with some scale. So here I am not going to write all these steps, I will define with the help of this diagram only. So as we all know, this OB is a link, this is called crank, and if we want to define the linear velocity of OB, so it will be perpendicular to this OB only. So VB will be perpendicular to OB. So here what we will do, we will draw a line OB. So first we have to mark a fixed point O, because O is on the fixed link only and this O is fixed point, it is not changing its position. So O will be fixed. So we will draw a line that will be perpendicular to OB, and it will be equivalent to magnitude VB or VBO. And direction will be in the direction of VB, perpendicular to OB, and it will be in upward direction. So this is representing the direction as well as the magnitude of velocity of point B with respect to point O. Now, how we can define the velocity of other terms like velocity of point A with respect to point B and velocity of slider A with respect to point O, because this slider is sliding with respect to this fixed link only. So what we will do here, if we want to define the velocity of this particular AB or connecting link or connecting rod, so here velocity vector will also perpendicular to AB. So here we have the direction of VAB, and with the help of this direction we have to define the magnitude of this VAB. So we will draw a line which is perpendicular to AB, and it will start from point B. So randomly I have drawn a line here from point B that is perpendicular to AB. Now, so randomly I have drawn a line here which is perpendicular to AB. Now we don't know the end point of this particular velocity vector, so I have not marked any point here. Now the second point, how we can mark? So here we have the velocity VA, and this VA we are considering parallel to this AO only. So, from point O, we will draw a line which is parallel to AO line. So, this line which is drawn from point B, perpendicular to AB, and the line which is parallel to AO, which is drawn from point O, it is intersecting at one point and I have marked that point as A. So, this particular line OA is representing the velocity of slider A, and this BA line is representing the velocity of slider A or point A with respect to point B. So, with the help of measurement, we can draw or we can find out the magnitude of these velocity VA and VAB. So, let's find out the dimensions. This particular OB we are considering as VB, and VB value we already have 8.37. So, here I have drawn this VB equals to 8.37 only on the scale, and this I have drawn on the basis of this particular concept of velocity analysis. So, by this way we can find out the value of VA and VAB. So, from the measurement we have the value of VAB, that is 4.5 meter per second, and VA we have, that is equals to OA, so it is 10.3 meter per second. So, this VBO is equals to OB, VAB is equals to BA, and VA is equals to OA. So, with the help of measurement, we have all these values. So, this is the velocity analysis of slider crank mechanism. Now, here what we have to find out? Here we have to determine the linear velocity and acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod. So, here I have marked point D as the midpoint. So, let us mark a point D which is at the midpoint of AB. So, here we can mark point D at the midpoint of BA also, because this is representing the velocity. So, here point D is dividing this A and B into a particular ratio, and that is half. So, here AD, that is equals to DB. So, here we can draw a point D at the midpoint of BA, because this BA is representing VAB. So, here I have marked point D at the midpoint of BA, or we can also define the position of this D on the basis of position of this capital D on AB. So, here the ratio which is defined by the position of point D on this AB connecting rod, we will consider that is equals to ratio which is defined by this point D on this VA vector. So, on the basis of this concept, here we are considering the same ratio. So, BD by BA, that is equals to capital BD by capital BA. And here we have all the values because this point D on the connecting rod is at the midpoint. So, it will be BD by BA. So, the ratio will be 1 by 2 only. So, BD we can define as 400 mm because the total AB is 800 mm. So, 400 mm divided by 800 mm or 0.4 by 0.8 meter. And BA value we have from here 4.5 meter per second. So, BD value we can define as 2.25 meter per second, or we can define manually because this point D is at the midpoint. So, at BA it will be also on the midpoint only. So, this BD is represented as 0.2.25 meter per second. Now, we want to define the velocity of point D. So, what we will do, we will join this O and D here, and velocity of point D with respect to point O, we can define by the measurement of this line OD. So, from measurement, we have defined OD as 8.9 meter per second. That is equals to VD. So, VD is representing the vector OD. That is equals to 8.9 meter per second. So, here we have the velocity or the linear velocity for the midpoint of the connecting rod. So, here first part has been completed. Now, the second part is acceleration of the midpoint of point D. So, for that we have to draw the acceleration diagram. So, if we want to define the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod, so we have to define the acceleration at each and every point, like the acceleration at point B with respect to point O, acceleration of point A with respect to point B, and the acceleration of slider And on that basis, we can define the acceleration on the midpoint D. So, first of all, we will define the acceleration component of point B with respect to point O. So, here we have the velocity. So, on the basis of velocity, we can define the acceleration component. And here OB is a crank and crank is rotating with constant angular velocity omega. Omega value we have. So, in that condition, this OB will have only radial component. It will not have any tangential component because of the constant angular velocity. So, here we will define the radial component of the acceleration of point B with respect to point O. So, here we have the formula of radial component of acceleration of point B with respect to point O, that is represented by AB. So, it will be VBO square by BO, that is the perpendicular distance. This is the formula and we have the value of VBO. So, it is 8.37 square divided by BO is 0.2. So, with the help of this value, we will define the radial component of acceleration of point B with respect to point O. It is 350.1 meter per second square. Now, here we don't need to define the tangential component because of the constant angular velocity of link BO. Now, next term is connecting rod. So, for connecting rod, we have to define both component, radial component as well as the tangential component. So, here if we want to define the radial component of acceleration of connecting rod AB, or we can also say radial component of acceleration of point A with respect to point B. So, this would be the formula ARAB, that is equals to VAB square by AB. So, here we have the value of VAB, that is the velocity component of point A with respect to point B. So, VAB we have 4.5 meter per second. And AB value we have, it is given in numerical, that is 800 mm. So, we will take 0.8 meter. So, the radial component of point A, radial component of acceleration of point A with respect to point B is 25.31 meter per second square. So, here we have the value of radial component. Now, next value we have to determine the tangential component of point A with respect to point B. So, if we want to define the tangential component of point A with respect to point B, we have to draw the acceleration diagram. And on the basis of measurement, we can define the tangential component of acceleration as well as the acceleration for other terms. So, let's draw the acceleration diagram. So, here we have this diagram where we know the velocities at each and every point with magnitude and directions. So, we will use those velocities, direction, and the dimensions of all the links to define the acceleration at different point. So, let's draw the acceleration diagram. So, here I will start with the fixed end or fixed point O. So, here I am not going to write all the steps. I have marked one fixed point O dash. So, I will explain verbally only about each and every line or each and every notation and each and every component of acceleration, either it is radial component or tangential component. So, here we have one component which is known, that is the radial acceleration of point B with respect to point O. So, it is represented by ARBO. So, it is represented by AB. Here we have this particular acceleration AB. So, 350.1 meter per second square. So, I have taken 3.5 to define the acceleration of point B. We can write down this as capital B also, or we can write down as small b. It depends on us, whatever notation we can define. So, AB is equals to O dash B dash. So, I have taken with suitable scale O dash B dash and we have the value that is around 350. So, I have taken 3.5 centimeter around in the direction of BO. Here, this particular line I have drawn parallel to BO. So, OB dash is representing the radial acceleration. Radial acceleration, how we can define? Radial acceleration we can define along the radius of the circle. So, this BO is the radius of the circle. So, in this particular direction, in downward direction, we will define the radial acceleration of BO. So, here we have the magnitude of AB. Now, again, we have acceleration for one link BO. Now, we have here AB, that is the connecting rod. So, for connecting rod, we have to define the radial acceleration as well as the tangential acceleration. But now, Radial acceleration for AB, we have 25.31 meter per second square. So, this particular value we will take with suitable scale to define the radial acceleration of AB. So, here before going to define the radial acceleration and tangential acceleration of connecting rod AB, I want to tell you one thing. So, I am repeating it again. Here we have defined O dash B dash as the radial component of acceleration of BO. So, here we will only define this radial component because this particular link BO is rotating or moving with constant angular velocity. So, there will be no existence of tangential component. So, here we have only one component. Now, for AB, we have to define both the component. So, ARAB and ATAB are represented as the radial component and tangential component, and both the components are perpendicular to each other. So, if we want to define ARAB. So, for ARAB, what we will do here, we will mark that radial component from this particular point B dash, and from B dash, we will draw a point B dash X, and that will be parallel to AB. So, with a suitable scale, I have drawn this component B dash X. It is very small because of the value. Here, we have ARBO as 350.1 and ARAB is 25.31. So, there is a huge difference. So, it will reflect in diagram also. So, this BX, this is the X point. So, at this particular X point, we are going to draw one perpendicular. So, this perpendicular I have drawn here. So, at the another point, we can draw X A dash. Somewhere I am marking A dash, that is the end point of this X A dash, and this X A dash will represent the tangential component. But here we don't have the magnitude. So, X A dash we have to find out. Now, next term I will use to define this tangential component. So, here we have another link, that is the slider. So, here slider we are considering from point, this particular point A, it is moving in this particular direction with velocity VA. So, this will be the direction of acceleration also. So, acceleration we will consider along AO line only. So, from point O dash, we will draw a line which is parallel to AO. And this particular line is intersecting this particular line, which is we have drawn from X perpendicular to B dash X. B dash X we have in magnitude. B dash X is representing ARAB. Now, on the basis of this B dash X, we can define the value of X A dash. So, this point we will consider as A dash. So, this O dash A dash is representing the acceleration of point A, and it is denoted by AA. So, here we have acceleration of this particular point. Now, what we will do? We have this A dash. So, we will join this B dash and A dash. So, after joining B dash A dash, this vector B dash A dash, this B dash A dash will represent the total acceleration of point A with respect to point B. And that is the summation of tangential acceleration and radial acceleration. And this acceleration we will define with the help of measurement. So, from the measurement we can define the value of tangential acceleration of point A with respect to point B. It is 290 meter per second. And we already have the radial acceleration. So, there is no need to define the value. Now, here A dash B dash is representing the total acceleration. So, from the measurement, we can define the AB or acceleration of point A with respect to point B, that is the total acceleration. So, it will be 315 meter per second square. So, here we have the value of acceleration, tangential and radial both. Now, this O dash A dash we can define with measurement. So, O dash A dash from the measurement, we will convert this into the actual scale. So, it will be 115 meter per second square. So, this diagram is small, and here I am converting whatever scale I have taken. So, this is the value of O dash A dash, that is representing AA or acceleration of slider A. So, here we have all the values of acceleration. Now, what we have to define? We have to define the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod AB. So, what we will do? We will mark point D here, and D is dividing in a particular ratio to AB. So if we mark any point D here on A dash B dash, so the point D dash will divide in the same ratio as this capital D is dividing the capital AB. So manually I have defined the position of D dash, that is at half of the A dash B dash, because this D is at the half of the AB, or we can define the position of D dash with the help of that concept of ratio. So as per this concept, B dash D dash by B dash A dash, this is we are considering for this acceleration diagram, and it is equals to BD by AB. Here we are considering same ratio for both the diagrams. So it will be here from this particular condition, we can define the value of B dash D dash, that is B dash A dash into BD by AB. So we will put all these values here. B dash A dash we have from the measurement. So here we have the final value of B dash D dash. It is 157.5 meter per second square. So from B dash, we will draw this point D. Now we will join this O dash D dash. So as per the measurement, we can have the acceleration at point D, it is 245 meter per second square. So this diagram we will prefer to define the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod. So here we have to draw the acceleration and the component of acceleration of each and every link with respect to some points, then only we can define the acceleration at the midpoint of the connecting rod. So by this particular concept, we can define the acceleration at point D. Now we have to define the angular velocity and angular acceleration of connecting rod when crank angle is 45 degree from the inner dead center position. So let's define the angular acceleration and angular velocity. So if we want to define the angular velocity of the connecting rod, so it is generally denoted by omega AB, and on the basis of VAB, we can define this omega AB. And as per the formula, we have this equation omega AB equals to VAB by AB. So we will put all these values here. So VAB we have 4.5 meter per second. So omega AB will be 5.625 radian per second. Now, if we want to define the angular acceleration of connecting rod, so with the help of tangential component of AB, we can define the angular acceleration. So here is the formula of angular acceleration of connecting rod. So it is equals to, it is denoted by alpha AB. So it is equals to AT AB by AB. So this tangential acceleration of point A with respect to point B we have from the measurement. So here we have the value 290 meter per second square. That is the value of tangential acceleration. So the final value of angular acceleration of connecting rod will be 362.5 radian per second square. Here we have angular velocity 5.625 radian per second and angular acceleration is 362.5 radian per second square. So here is the solution. Thank you so much.